everyone, this is Jack and welcome back to my channel. This is day six of the Texas Eclipse trips. We have an extra day due to the cancellation of the festival, and so this was us touring Austin part one.
Lady Bird Lake. After L.B. Johnson, his wife.
So I think that's the manor. There's a walkway that goes around the whole place that people run on and stuff. But if we take this trail, we'll be by the Rainy Street.
Rainy Street Historic District is a street of homes that are made in the bungalow style in downtown Austin. Rainy Street is positioned near Lady Bird Lake and Interstate 35 in the southeast corner of downtown. The area is roughly 12 acres. Many of the original houses have been converted into bars and restaurants, making it popular for nightlife.
The weed dispenser.
Hell yeah.
The weed vending machine.
That's a lot. That room in the park.
Yes. More yes.
Is it booty or bote?
Booty. Axolotls.
We decided to start out with the Nature and Science Center, which is actually free. And then later on, you'll see that it's just so hot. I can't stand it in my sweats due to the humidity. And so we actually go to the mall to try to grab a t-shirt and a pair of shorts because I need relief.
Camina el sendero del bosque.
Oh yeah, Austin has bats.
They have a salamander sanctuary.
What?
How do you know these things?
Reddit.
They're big.
Questions.
Oh, you could have brought your water bottle.
So Austin Nature and Science Center is an 80-acre nature center featuring educational exhibits including replicas of fossils and dinosaur tracks. Unfortunately, this area was closed for rehabilitation, but the rest of the stuff was still open. It's a great place to bring kids and learn about wildlife, very family friendly, and you can park by the underpasses that are a short walk away. I think this is really cool. Upon entry, you could actually trade whatever types of things that are listed on their chalkboard for something that they already have. It's like a display case. So for example, if you found something that's not on their property, but within Austin, they will honor whatever it is that you find. And then you collect points and the point system will allow you to trade later on. They also have a bunch of rocks and minerals and crystals that are included in their trade system. You can find other bones and taxidermy type of animals. It's really cool. I wish they had this in California.
Seed library. Oh. That's so cool. soil map, 1973. And then outer space. It looks like a puzzle. I wonder if the preschool uses this. Space scientist. That YouTube chick, she collects rainwater to water her. I feel like it's sleeping. Oh, this fence is in front. Hello. Are labeled wrong.
Well, Harold and Maude were released into Austin.
Oh. Stay quiet. They won't notice me here. Yeah. Tell them. Sleeping up there. This is down there. Yeah. You're so flat. Slither me timbers. Oh yeah. It looks fake. Oh, you can't capture him. Rough green snakes. I don't think that's it. But those are these bats. Where? Where? Did you escape from one of the exhibits? No? Okay. Just chilling. Where? Oh yeah. Cheat, cheat, motherfucker. Thanks. The people working at Apple. Nah. Chico.
What's up, Chico?
Oh, the other one's probably broken. Yeah. Turkey vulture. Curly. Yeah, these are all females. She also has a broken wing, but she looks like she could flap it. Roadrunner. You're the Roadrunner, and you're the Blue Jay.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Oh, hi.
Hello.
Pretty bird.
Oh, yeah, she's napping. Look, I'm one eye open. Benji. So that means that Harry Potter had a barn owl. Love those sigils. Leave no trace, like Burning Man. Scenic overlook. Humidity is great for the skin, but it's really, really, really hot.
Okay, so.
Well, we were gonna do this anyway today.
Right, but now feels a good time to read because we're not.
There were so many birds under this underpass, and I don't know why. They were flying like crazy. But yeah, next up is the mall.
Dragon Town. Who are you?
6 months.
Bruh. Pools. Oh, it's so humid outside that it's supposed to look like this. It's of colorful stuff. KitchenAid's on sale. And then Breville's a really, really good brand. Awesome. You got a whole Smeg section. Okay, we like that. Forever. Oh no. It's $3 though. Oh no. Oh no. They're my size. Help. Okay, are these $3 too? Because I'm in trouble if they are. This one will fit in my bag. Cute. Oh, kind of broken here though. Girl, Texas fashion though. Holy crap.
Okay, I'm not sponsored by fast fashion or anything, but I do have to say that the colors, patterns, and textures in this store were out of this world. Literally, like, I've never seen a Forever 21 in LA that has this much variety and differences in styles in one sitting. Even my partner was impressed. We were there for a very long time. Of course, up front had the fringe, the cowboy hats and boots, and the Daisy Dukes. But behind that was festival season, and oh my gosh, do they have a bunch of iridescent holographics, shiny dangling rhinestone stuff that I have never seen before in my life. Fully stocked.
Interesting. Oh my goodness.
Of course they have Beyonce playing in the background. Hold'em, Texas.
I am, thank you.
Like, what is this? What are you supposed to put in there? Also, what is it made out of? Plastic?
Definitely festy fashion, bro. Oh, they have a hair floss here too. I don't get this mermaid collection, but I'm dig it. Oh my god. What is happening? Oh my god, I can't. And the crochet.
You can. What are you doing with the hats?
They're $3. Oh my god.
think those were attached by pearl buttons. But this is kind of cute too. So is this. Three doll hairs.
Bed. $19. Yeah. I'm down. Oh my god, the camo. I can't.
$17.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Yes. Girl.
Goyle.
Okay, so I looked it up, and the Mermaid Collection is literally just the umbrella term for the cutest festival mesh sets, sparkly swimwear, and so much more for all sizes. I mean, come on, look at these prints, man.
That's still less than LA. $9. Wow, look at all this. Whoa.
$17. Yeah, I'm not a size 27. Even at my smallest, I was like a 28 or 29.
Squishy, 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 squishy.
I really like these fabrics too. It's like interesting. Okay, all of this section was at least 30% off or more, and it depended on, I guess, the style or the season, because the older seasons like winter and the heavier coats and stuff were going to be at a higher percentage off, and then the newer stuff that was into spring and summer were still within, you know, the seasons that are coming up, so those were less of a discount, but it was still a really good deal. So in conjunction with the festival season, they also had like a four collaboration, as well as Hello Kitty. They had Coca-Cola. So all of these huge brands were getting featured on t-shirts and stuff like that. And honestly, it's free advertising at this point.
I love how they organize this.
Oh my god, I'm living.
Ooh, very 90s. Fun for like in a black version of this. I don't even know what this is, but it's cute. They look like sleeves. Oh yeah, it is. Oh, these are so fun. What kind of thing is this? It feels like latex, but it's not. Where's the tag? Oh man. That's sick, bruh. How much? Is it my size? Oh my god. It's very 90s. Ugh. Textures, the patterns. Like, look at that. Wow. It's like a plastic.
Pockets.
Bruh, it's all pockets. So flipping cool. What the heck is this even? Dress? You want pockets on your sleeves? Ooh. Cute. Oh my gosh. So pretty. $5. Okay. Wait, hold it. $7 for this. That's more material than this. Ooh, cute. 15.
love.
Oh my gosh, I love this too. How much is that?
Oh my god, is this the Hellfire Club? Yes!
You look stinking cute, bro.
Mickey and Minnie. Let's check out that.
So my partner picked out my outfit for me, and it was very comfortable and can mix and match with a bunch of things, and I think it ended up being under $10, which was a steal, so I bought it.
Very much so.
Juicy.
Sanrio.
Stuff.
Of course I do. Do you prince? Moose. Swans. Oh my god. Pineapples.
Okay. That's an old photo then.
Yeah, we from there too.
Which type of festy are you?
All five and our crap, because it's filled with stuff.
Yes, but we could keep the stuff in there.
My god, a London fog. And look at the wheels. This is everything I want.
You like gunmetal? You got that too? Matching sets. Bruh. Definitely no shortage here. Holy.
Sick. Oh, look at this one too. Pretty. Like a modern Hawaiian shirt kind of situation.
This is fun.
Yeah. Your shirt is better though. Cute.
So like $24.
Cute. Ooh, this ombretto. Oh. Sick. Of course it's INC. I wonder if it's because it's Texas. That's cool. This would be good for Cancun. Look at all this winter wear.
Yeah. Well, it actually gets cold here, so.
I would wear these.
Fun.
Ooh, I like these. So? It's cute. I know my brands by looking at the
good quality.
Yeah, that's what I said.
You said you knew your brand.
Oh, just like Levi's over here. Preach.
Gorgeous. These are on sale too. INC.
50% off. Boba. Oh, it is boba. Cute.
I got the Strauss. What is your Strauss? Okay. Stabo.
Chad.
No, but it doesn't make sense. Why?
Hey, you got a powerful
penguin.
Oh, I love this wallpaper.
She's not my style.
Forest Fairy. Ooh, look at those pants.
What's it got?
meow shrooms.
Oh my god. So cute.
Shh. Cat loaf.
Okay, so luckily they do have an Earthbound here in California. It is a little far, but at least we have them close by because they had everything that I wanted. From festivals, to hippies, to fairies, and everything in between.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh, yeah.
Cute. They don't, oh my god, the gold. They don't have stuff like this in LA.
It's good.
Oh my gosh. You would wear this.
That rocks.
Hell yeah. Swiss wisdom.
Ooh,
oh my god.
It's so cute. Cute.
That's for you.
Okay, so Earthbound Trading Company started in the 90s by Steve and Susanna Gordon. They were actually a rock and mineral shop with unique crystals curated from Susanna's home country in Brazil. 25 years later, Susanna is the sole owner, making Earthbound a woman-owned business. They have around 150 shops that are locations and then an online website. They try to have global concepts, celebrate diversity, have transparency and honesty, while being free-spirited as a lifestyle. They explore a world of artisanal crafts, bohemian fashion, and globally inspired home decor, nomadic spirit, and curious heart. I really wonder if the decor here is different from other places. It's pretty similar to California, but there are some things that are a little weirder, and just like Portland, Austin likes to stay weird. So yeah, that was something interesting that I observed here.
Impressing me much.
Ooh, ooh. So you got alien heads right next to tarot deck sleeve, next to other stickers that are nature based, but I feel like you could put this all under Renfair, minus the aliens.
Need all the money sticks.
Bento box. So cute. Mushrooms.
Oh, I love this. Showed Davila. Oh my god.
I'm gonna tell Davila we saw Scream and he's not using this shit.
Preach, girl. Preach. Crystals and more. What's with the McLarens, bruh? Oh my god. This shark. That's why I'm taking a video. Oh my god, my mom would have a field day. See, this is how they get you, with clearance and only a dollar. $11.
Anyway, that's all the crazy stuff that we saw in this part one. Stay tuned for part two next Saturday. Subscribe and click the notification bell so you know when. Until then, keep curious, everyone. Jack out.